This is Dr. Dean Kelaita, Calaveras County Health Officer, with a Calaveras COVID-19 report for today, May 26, 2020. The United States is pushing up against 100,000 coronavirus deaths. As of today, there are 80,000 cases of COVID-19 infection in California, with 3,300 deaths. Calaveras County now has 14 confirmed cases. The most recent case was reported Saturday, May 23rd, in an adult male residing in the upper Highway 4 corridor region of Calaveras County. Calaveras Public Health staff will continue to investigate this new case to determine any possible persons who may have had close personal contact with the positive individual. Close contacts will be assessed and monitored for signs and symptoms of COVID-19 illness. The source of this infection for this new case still remains unknown at this time, indicating there could have been community transmission. Mark Twain Medical Center has been able to resume non-emergency elective procedures, such as cancer treatment, cancer screening tests, endoscopy, and orthopedic surgeries. Our healthcare system retains enough hospital beds, ICU space, ventilator capacity, and PPE, personal protective equipment, to care for a surge of coronavirus patients in the future if needed. Nursing homes across America are home to less than 0.5% of our population, yet they've accounted for over 1/3 of coronavirus deaths nationwide. Avalon Nursing Home in San Andreas has undergone complete coronavirus testing of all of its residents and all of the staff who care for them. All results have come back negative, indicating the facility remains free of COVID-19 disease. Protecting the lives of our high-risk seniors remains one of my highest concerns and priorities. As most people are aware, the state of California accepted Calaveras County's attestation to be granted a variance to move further along into stage 2 of the governor's 4-stage pandemic roadmap to reopening the state and the economy. This variance was granted to our county because we've demonstrated low enough rates of coronavirus infections, the ability to track and contact trace any new cases to interrupt local disease transmission, to have the capacity to test 1.5 per thousand of our residents every day for COVID-19 illness, and to ensure the hospital has enough space, equipment, and PPE to respond to a resurgence of disease if it comes. To improve and expand our ability to provide testing to our population, our community, together with Tuolumne County, has been chosen to receive an Optum testing site. This is a dedicated state funding testing site for COVID-19 PCR testing that will be located at the Calaveras County Frogtown Fairgrounds in Angels Camp. Once all appropriate agreements are signed, our goal is to have this testing site operational by this Friday, May 29th. Information on how to schedule testing appointments by the public are posted on our website, and we'll have a press release about this, including internet-based ways of making an appointment or calling a toll-free 800 telephone number. Once operational, the OptumServe site will be able to accommodate 120 to 140 persons per day in Calaveras and Tuolumne counties. Because of the approval of our local variants, many local Calaveras businesses are now able to resume activities such as in-restaurant dining and in-store shopping, as long as the businesses comply with common sense safety plans. These plans require continuing social distancing and disinfection procedures shown to reduce the spread of the virus among the business's employees and customers. New guidance has also just been released today by the state of California, allowing for counties such as Calaveras that have been granted variance that moves hair salons, barbershops, churches and houses of worship, and all retail shopping into the enhanced stage 2 category of allowable activities. Specific infection control procedures like physical distancing guidelines, employee training requirements will still need to be implemented, but this is a good move forward for us. So people can now get their hair cut again, Churches can resume in-person worship services at 25% of their building occupancy, up to 100 attendees. Funerals already have specific guidelines. Weddings will not be permitted. Additional in-person services provided by churches, such as counseling, AA, and other 12-step programs, are and will be allowed. Day camp guidance should be released later this week. The public is still highly recommended and encouraged to wear a face covering when in public when they'll be near others. A face covering is just a cloth mask as opposed to a medical mask. Mass gatherings and other large-scale venues such as concerts, conventions, sporting events remain closed at this time. The governor will announce further expansion of allowable business and recreational activities according to the stages 3 and 4 of the state's roadmap to recovery if the COVID-19 pandemic continues to improve and stabilize. Public Health has worked with the school districts to allow for and design drive-through graduation ceremonies to recognize the hard work of our graduating students. In addition to the public, the frontline soldiers against coronavirus are our doctors, nurses, EMTs, and other local health officials. The health system exists in local hospitals, not federal health agencies. Avalon Skilled Nursing Facility is home to our greatest generation that fought and won our wars of the 20th century. We owe it to them to remain vigilant and protective of their lives and safety. This pandemic is by no means over. As I've said before, using the baseball analogy, we're currently in the 3rd inning of a 9-inning game. This crisis will remain with us until there's an effective vaccine available to provide protection to the entire public. So it's up to us to keep our community safe. Further information, including more specifics on the Frogtown OptumServe testing site, will be put out by the Public Health Department, and you can get more information by visiting our website. Thank you for your support, and thank you for your efforts to keep Calaveras County safe and prevent COVID-19 infection in some of our most vulnerable residents.